Alright, sorry about that. That's my cat. Once again, I memory stuff.
Hi, Spyro. You must be tougher than you look to get here. All the same, you won't be able to get past the metal sharks up ahead. I suppose I could let you borrow my submarine, though. For a modest fee, of course. A pleasure doing business with you, Spyro. This submarine is 100% shockproof. I guarantee it.
You pretty much have to pay, because if you go swimming through there, you'll automatically be greeted with those four metal sharks. And like I said earlier, they are very hard to take out. And you need the super flame power to take them out as well. Alright. Charge you, hit you, press that. Alright, it's all full up. Subs despawned because it went off steam. Have we got enough deaths? No, we do not. How many have we got? 11, and I need 14. That's being, of course, by enemy's home. From enemy's home. Well, not us dying, but just them. If you know what I mean.
Our world is wet again. We all want you to have this talisman of Aquaria Towers to remember us by.
I know there's a couple of enemies nearby that like that would help, but they require the super flame power up, so I'm gonna have to search ones that don't need it.
Hop aboard, Spyro.
Yeah, he'll stay there, and to use it, you have to talk to him, but. But coming through it for the first time, you'll automatically start talking to him, and he'll say the same thing every time. Up aboard, Spyro. Got some gems. Nope. We don't have enough still. Let me try again. Except this time I'll go the opposite direction once I find him. I'm not going anywhere near there, so yeah. But I'll swim back this way. Because, as you've seen there, sharks. So yeah, let's do this. See, they count. Got them. I can get this. Alright, be against. It's worth killing them. Just save treasure over. Okay, down here. Here for the next bunch. And there's 12 in the next. Area, I believe. Because there's only four there. I think there's like, no, not 12, there's like 16.
Mm-hmm.
lockjaw. So there was actually seven of them down here, leading to a total of 11 sharks in the entire stage. But anyways, you've seen the trophy, it's lockjaw. You get that for killing all 11 sharks. Anyways, here's two of them. And it's much easier now.
I'm trying to tame my new pet manta ray, but he just won't obey me. Hey, we're just about the right size to ride on his back. Great! Hop on his back and guide him through each of the bubble rings as they appear. And remember, he's brand new, so try not to get him dented or scratched up.
Plus, it actually tells you how many there are this time. It's also easier because it's much more simple to control the ray.
Well done! I suppose I owe you something for that. Here, take this orb. I found it in one of my flippers.
Okay.
Now that the manta ray's tamed, I'd love to get him into racing shape. Care to take him through a harder course? Okay, good luck.
Only slightly harder, though. And yes, there are a total of 17 rings this time. I used to always fail in the original. But this one is a little bit more difficult. Sure, it's still easy to control, but the manta ray goes a bit faster this time. Making it a bit easier to miss the rings completely.
Incredible! You've got real talent. I could use a partner like you. You can have the orb I found in my other flipper, too.
Alright. 16 orbs.
Workers have kidnapped six of my children and have hidden them in the top of each of these numbered towers. I borrowed some explosives to blast open the tower doors. If you can make it to the top of the six numbered towers, my children will be safe.
Okay, the first one's pretty easy, but they get harder and harder. And all obstacles except obstacles that are known and rendered and programmed as enemies will go away once you complete eat the place. Ah! Yeah, I'll have to get a sheep on the way. There's a couple outside. He's on. There's another. Okay. There's some more gems, and I've seen another sheep up there, I believe. Do that, or have my eyes playing tricks on me? But there's another sheep. There we go. Now the third one's back down where we started. Alright, there's the third one. Yeah, there's only an enemy in here. But like I said earlier, it won't go away. Four is off this way. Wait, what? Oh, that's five. You don't think four is back where I came? Oh, yep, there it is. Yeah, this one's a bit more dangerous compared to the others. Now, we've seen where fire was. So, yeah, then you go this way. I believe we've seen where six was. I usually take the long way around, but this time I'm going to take the shortcut. Alright. That's all six of them.
You did it! Now we can swim in peace! I heard that you're collecting orbs. Please, take this one.
Okay! All orbs collected. Now there's still a few gems though. There's a few. Also, because I'm playing on the PlayStation 4, my light bar changes depending on my health. Like, look. Right now it's blue. But if I were to get this sheep here, if I could get it. Look. It would change to yellow, indicating full health. It would also be green if he were green. And it would flicker red, I believe, if you were to... Well, it would go out if he disappeared, but it would flicker red should you get hit again, meaning that you're pretty much dead. Because you only get three hits, and after that, if you get hit again, you're down. Down for the count. Oh, he's saying they're underneath, so they're back down. Yeah, you can use sparks to point yourself in the direction of gems that you've missed. Saying that there's some over in the other room. Alright. Why now? Oh, I see one. Okay. Now. Oh, he's saying they're back the way. Chances are they're in the other room. Oops, let me go the other way. Okay, where are we? Same or this way? Oh yeah, I remember this. Thank you. crabs are nightmarish, right? Okay, we've almost got anything. I mean, enchanted shell is the name of the talisman here. Any more? Oh, he's pointing straight down. Oh, I see them. That's definitely not all of them, though. Any more? Pointing down again. Oh, they're down there. There we are. Actual cutscene for this is really funny, so I'm gonna take the go to the portal so that you can see it. Ow. He really thought that was a fake one. Might not be funny to everybody, but still. The fact that he thought it was fake. And the other one thought it was real when it was fake. And then him thinking it was fake when it was real. I swear. Two. Absolute heck. Anyways. After Aquaria Towers, what have we got? I don't know.
Well done, Spyro.
Oh, that's right, the boss fight.
Six talismans. This door will open.
Let's go face him.
Before you get to the castle dungeon, Spyro, I thought that you might want to know how Ripto and his monsters arrived in Avalar. You see, last week in the winter tundra, the professor was working on some new super portal technology.
There, that's the last orb in place. Now let's see. All we need are some coordinates.
Yeah? How about 22475?
That's my birthday.
Let me guess. The 22nd of April. 1975, if I got the numbers right. Matching up. Oh god.
Why can't either of you? Where are we?
Now here's what doesn't make sense.
No dragons? Wonderful.
Crush, go back and pack my bags. We're moving in.
Say hello to your new kid.
Professor, shut it down. Hurry.
Oh my, oh my. I can't see the switch. I think I've broken my glasses.
The portal, you idiot.
Tell your friends to take the orbs and scatter them throughout Avalar. Quickly. Why didn't you chase him?
I would have gone after him, but didn't he say something about not liking dragons?
Which is absolute.
Can you catch a dragon to help us?
Oh crap, since he.
Yes, I think so.
Crush kind of looks like a dragon to me.
Much better suited to intercepting one of these creatures. How about glimmer?
See what I mean? He kind of looks like a dragon, doesn't he? Anyways. Here we go. Oh my gosh. Now I've got to run away, because if you don't run away, you're going to get hit. I'm also going to show the quickest way I know to beat him. He keeps chasing you till he gets close enough. So I kind of wait, and then I back off. And that's crushed down for the count.
Now, crush!
You may have been able to defeat that simpleton, but God will be more than a match for you.
Bring it on, Shorty.
Go, come here now.
Okay, you didn't need to blast the door wide open. I'm not looking to the gold boss fight, as it's been made much harder in the remake. Okay. Crush defeated. Moving on to the awesome plains.
That Ripto has caused enough damage. All his meddling has cost me a fortune. If it wasn't for Spyro, I'd be bankrupt. If Ripto were here, I'd give him a piece of my mind.
Then don't turn around.
I'd give him a lot more than that. I was a champion bantamweight boxer at university, and I still know a few moves. Take that.
The way he went, ooh, after everyone breaks, and went to the ground and gulped at it too. But yeah. Here we are now in the autumn plains. Now, first things first, learn how to climb.
Well, I bet a rich dragon like you wouldn't mind cashing in a few gems to learn how to climb. I'd be willing to teach you for, say, a small fee. You won't regret it. Okay, when you see a wall surface that looks climbable,
like that one,
like the one to my left here, just jump onto it, and you will grab it with your claws. Use the left stick to move up and down. press the jump button again to leap off. You can also jump sideways onto another climbable area.
Let's head back to the summer forest. Just for a sec. And next time, I believe, since we're running out of time, we're going to do so two or three of the stages in the Autumn Plains. Haven't, I don't know which ones though. Anyways, here we are. Let's go down here. Up here. Jump up, and up, and up, and up. Now we can climb up here and get these. A few gems. The last orb, bringing our total to 18. All orbs collected. And that's not every gem. There are two missing. And Sparks is saying there. I should probably grab that for a gulp fight later. Staying in here.
Nice work, Spyro. The orbs you're carrying have activated the special portal. You won't find a talisman in Ocean Speedway, but if you're fast, you'll get lots of treasure. Have fun.
Also, let me know if you want me to do the speedways. I'm guessing it's outside, but yeah, we're just about running out of time now, so I'm going to thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the very next episode, whatever the heck I do next, so see ya.